Hello, welcome back to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video we are going to learn how to schedule the jobs in Spring Boot. And this video is all about scheduled jobs. Scheduled jobs or tasks are piece of business logic that should run on scheduled basis mainly every some period of time. And Spring Boot provides some annotation that tell the IOC container to run a particular method on scheduled basis. And to enable the scheduling in our project, we need to add annotation that is @enableScheduling on class level and @scheduledAnnotation at method level. Okay, let's see in the code how to denote this annotation. First, I will go to Google Chrome. Here I will type start.spring.io and here I will define the project, that is Maven project, and language we are using Java, and Spring Boot version is 2.2. And here I will define the package name com.gain.java.knowledge, and here I will define the artifact ID that will be scheduler demo. So here I will define scheduler, and it will now I will generate. Here now we'll extract this file. Let's just open this folder and copy the path from here and go to Eclipse and click on the Eclipse, import the project, that is will be existing Maven project, paste here, browse and finish. Now I will see the code here. It is a source main Java and it is a package name that I have defined, and it is our main class, and we can enable the scheduling by using, as we know, by using @enableScheduling annotation. By annotating this annotation, the scheduler will be enabled in our project, but you can use in main class, but this may raise an issue while unit testing or integration testing. Enable scheduling annotation, it will enable the scheduling, and this may cause some problems when we are using spy or mock beans during testing. So I will recommend it to create a separate or dedicated class for this annotation. Okay, let's create one more package. New package that will be config, and here I will create one more class. First I will refresh new class scheduler config, and on this class I will declare this annotation. From here I will cut, and on this class I will use this annotation. After and we can enable or disable the scheduling by provide some annotation of Spring Boot, that is @conditionalOnProperty, and here I will define the name that is will be equal to scheduling dot enabled, my match if missing will be true. We can enable or disable scheduling by applying this conditional on property annotation. If scheduling dot enable property is missing, then it will be disabled. So in case of testing we can make it disabled. And now I will put @configuration annotation, then Spring Boot will understand this configuration. And now we can turn any method on Spring Bean or Spring Configuration class into scheduled method by annotating @scheduledAnnotation, because now scheduling is enabled in our project, and we can define @scheduledAnnotation on any method to enable the scheduling. add the scheduled method. Here I will define some method, public void first job, and this method return type would be void, and no need to define any parameter here. And here I will print the current time, that is current time. Now current time plus new date, that is java.util.date. Okay, now I need to tell spring bean what interval spring should run this method, and there are couples of option. One is that first I will use scheduled annotation. Here it provides lots of way. Fixed rate, why will define fixed rate when the method should be run after how many interval. So here I will define 2000L. Now this method will execute each 2 second. Okay, let's see. Right click here and run as Java application. Now we will see the job will execute after each 2 seconds, and here will the time. You can see 19 21 23, every each 2 second it's going to execute. Here you can see the time difference is 2 seconds for every invocation. Now I will add some extra code inside the job, that is here I will define like this. I will define here thread dot sleep for 1000 millisecond. It will throw the exception, that is interrupted exception I must need to handle, and add throws declaration. So let's run this application again. Run as Java application. Now you will see the output. Here each invocation will start after 2 seconds when first invocation will be complete. Now you will see here the time difference is same, 2 seconds for each invocation. Now I will replace the fixed rate with fixed delay. Here now output will be changed. Now I will stop this job and will run again this application. The next invocation will be start after 2 seconds when the first invocation will be complete. So let's see here. Now the time difference is 3 seconds. 00 03 and 06, because when the job will be complete then the next invocation will be start. It's the meaning of fixed delay. Here you can see on console the difference is 3 seconds, 1 second for job execution and 2 second delay. We can also use some other option with fixed delay also, like that is initial delay is also here, and that means how much time it should wait after the context tips up. And here I have defined initial delay is 1000L. It's meaning when the context server is up, after that after 1 second it will be start our job. So here that I have defined 1000L means 1 second. And there are couple of ways that decide how job should run, that is fixed rate annotation will decide after how much time job will execute, and here at the rate fixed delay will decide the time when first invocation will complete and how much time it should wait for the next invocation. And initial delay is mainly used, that will decide that how much time job should take wait when the context is up. If I want to run my job after every 6 minutes, then what I will do, I will write here 60,000 L. Now my job will execute after every 6 minutes. And the first it will print. And if I want to execute my job, it will take times to print on console. And if I want to print run my job after every 1 hour, then I will type here like 36. Now my job will execute after fixed delay, that is 1 hour. And we can also write fixed delay is like this, 60 multiply by 60 and multiply by 1000 L. Now my job will also execute after each 1 hour, but for a code reader it is not easy to understand this, so we can here also use that fixed delay string annotation, that is fixed delay string here, that is fixed delay string. And here I will define for 1 hour, we can define pt1h. now my job will execute after every 1 hour. And for 10 minutes, if I want to execute my job after every 10 minutes, then I will write here pt10m. And like this, for every 10 seconds, I will write here PT10S. So my job will execute after every 10 seconds. So if I want to customize my job or schedule the job, then we need to change in the code. So here we can use @spring expression and referring to the property file. So here we can use fixed delay string. Will read this value from our property file by using spring expression. Here we'll define the delay time, delay dot time, no need to use double quote here, just copy this from here. Like this, we need to define @fixedDelay string, and by using spring expression, it will read this value from property file. So we need to write here, and now my job will execute after each 1 second. Now I will run the application, and now it will start to execute the job. And here you will see the time difference, that will be 2 seconds, because we have used thread.sleep for 1 second, and 1 second is fixed delay time. Here you can see the difference, that is 2 seconds. And we can also use the cron expression in the place of fixed delay string. And scheduled cron job expression have format that schedule the jobs. So cron expression has 6 fields separated by space, that is first star for seconds and star for minute and third star for hour. Like this, we can define here, this is a cron expression format, and we can define multiple stars, 6 stars here. And in the place of fixed delay string, we can define this, and this we will learn in the next part. Okay, thanks.